video, I'm going to show you how to do correlation in SPSS and write that up for a results section. And so it's actually really easy to do, but first thing you need is a data set that has at least two continuous variables for Pearson's correlation, and they need to be set next to each other side by side like this, because remember, each person gets their own row, and so you have to have scores on both variables. So to run a correlation, I always tell people to start by looking at the scatter plot to know what to expect. So we're going to make a scatter plot of this data to look at what we would expect the correlation to be. So let's go graphs and chart builder. And so one quick word of warning is that the variables need to be defined. And so what you can do, and so you'll see here, it's got the little three dots next to it. That means that it's listed as a categorical variable. You can change that in variable view. Here, let me close this. Here under measure, and so I can change that to scale. You will not be able to add a line of best fit unless they're both listed as scale. So you want to make sure that you have that set up correctly. Or once you get to chart builder, so graphs, chart builder, you can right click on them and change them in chart builder. Sometimes chart builder doesn't refresh, and so if it's still acting funny, just close everything out and start over. So let's hit scatter dot here. And we're going to pick the first one because it's a simple scatter plot. Okay, so you can double click or drag and drop to the main design window. Put one of your variables on X and one of them on Y. Now, if it's a true correlational design, it does not matter which one's X or Y because you're not predicting the direction of the relationship. If you're doing more of a regression type design, you might predict the direction. So we've got a rating here for femininity, and we're using that to predict sympathy. All right, and then let's hit OK. Now, since this is a Likert type scale data, it's going to look a little funny. And so this isn't an incorrect graph, it's just that the points can only be 4 or 5 or 6, so you don't have anything in the between. So don't, when you get a sort of graph like this, remember that while we consider it continuous, it doesn't have any decimals. And so the first thing to look at is, like, which direction do the dots seem to go? And I'd say it's probably a negative relationship because the majority of the dots lean to the left. So as this feminine variable is going up, sympathy is going down. But we do have these two kind of outliery dots out here. And so while not generally done for a correlation, what you could do is double click on this and add the line of best fit. So here, add fit line at total. That will be grayed out if they're not both scale, remember. Click on that. And it will add the regression line for you. Now, that's not part of correlation, but it will tell you which direction you would expect the relationship to go. So not what I expected, probably because of these two dots out here. So we're going to try this again in a second without those two dots to show you the importance of outliers. So that line really, that is the regression equation, but we're just doing correlation, so it helps me see, okay, I would expect a positive correlation. So to get the actual correlation, let's go analyze, correlate, bivariate. We're going to move over both variables, and then hit OK. And it says the correlation is 0.183. Open word here. Now, SPSS does assume that you're kind of dumb sometimes, and so it gives you everything twice. Okay, so let's make this bigger so you can see it here. There we go. All right, so it's given me the correlation. So you want to look here where it says Pearson correlation and go across. And so we want to use this line here where it's 1.183. Don't use sig, that's the p-value, and don't use n. And so if a correlation is not significant, it can kind of look like you should be using sig, but don't do that. So we're going to list this as R, and it's a lowercase r, is 0.18. And then you also list the p-value. Remember, when it's 0, 0, 0, you do less than 0, 0, 1. Okay, so it gave us a positive correlation between the two. Now that is significant because it is less than 0.05 here under the significance column. But think about this for a second. That correlation almost looks negative, but it's a small positive correlation. We have a huge N. Okay, so 369 people is a lot of people for correlation. So I'd probably think like, that might not be that important of a correlation, because remember, with power, any correlation can be significant with enough people in it. Okay, so that's how I would do correlation. But let's try this one more time, this time without the outliers. So the data set that I've used in this has a 1-7 scale, but it has some typos in it, as I use this to talk about data screening in my other class. And so what's happened is we've got two people with 9s when we really shouldn't, right? So the data only goes up to 7. So I'm going to delete those people, or those scores. It will automatically exclude them because they don't have both scores. And let's try this again, this time without the outliers. So graphs, chart builder. Okay. And like I said, sometimes it doesn't reset. So just to make sure I get the same, the appropriate graph, I'm going to hit reset and build it again. So feminine on X, sympathy on Y. Okay. And now it looks even less clear what the relationship should be. Right? So let's try double clicking on it and adding the line. Let me take that off this time. So you'll see that it's still positive. And so that's why I always tell people to add the line just in case they don't see it or they're not used to looking at these sort of graphs, because if you just glance at this, it really does look negative because it seems to have this left-leaning shape. What you're not seeing is the fact that there are way more dots over here on the right side than you think. So one problem with using data that overlaps a lot, where lots of people have the same combination of scores, is that that's not necessarily apparent in the way that SPSS graphs these. So look at these dots next to each other. So you see here how they're kind of lightly colored and then they get bolder and bolder. Well, when they're bolder like that, that means there are multiple dots in that one spot. And so just looking at this graph, you might guess that it's a negative correlation. But when you run it, you're going to get a positive number. That's why I kind of suggest adding the line. You're not really supposed to in the sense that you're not doing regression, but I think it will help you see maybe what to expect when you run the correlation. So let's see what taking out those two people did to our R score. So analyze, correlate, bivariate. It's already set up. I'm going to hit OK. And that brought up the score to 202. So I would report R instead. 0.20, it's still less than 001. So outliers do have an effect on correlations. In this case, it brought them down. It tends to break them down, but not always. Sometimes it'll artificially inflate your correlation. So that is how you report correlations and thinking about how to look at these graphs and outliers in SPSS.